Hello? The longest-serving security guard at the Tribune Tower. Good morning, sir. Hello?
What's going on there?
Hello?
Good morning.
Is this Alfred?
Who are you?
Is this Edwin?
No.
Wait. Let me guess. Mortimer.
No.
Mortimer. Is this Mortimer?
No.
Seymour.
No.
Emmett.
No.
Emmett. You're Emmett.
No.
Amos.
No.
Chester. You got to be Chester.
No.
What about
no.
Gus?
No.
You sound like a Gus to me.
No.
Ralph?
None of those guys are here.
What about Ralph? Are you Ralph?
This is Clarky O'Clyburn.
All right. Clark, nice to meet you. And you are the oldest security guard
Why did you need all those peoples?
Well, I was trying to figure out what your name was. I thought we'd have a fun time together.
Who is this?
This is Steve Cochran, and you're on the radio at 720 WGN here in the Tribune Tower.
I've been in the security guard here since 1925.
Right, and that's why we wanted to talk to you. I can't imagine the things you've seen.
Well, I don't see as much as I used to.
Right, no, I understand that. Do you have any memories of Wally Phillips?
Wally, Mr. Phillips, was a great guy. He would come down, and I'd let him in. He always brought me a cup of milk.
Because you like milk?
No, I can't stand it. I'm I can't drink it.
What about Bob Collins? What are your Bob Collins memories?
Bobby was so much fun with me. He was a great guy. He didn't bring me nothing.
Okay, all right. I didn't know that was the currency. Yeah. Mike Royko from the Chicago Tribune, what about that?
Mike Royko he'd let me read those articles before he signed them out into the papers.
You were Mike Royko's proofreader?
He'd say, is this spelled correctly? And I go, I don't know.
See, a very early form of spell check.
Hey, Clark, it's Justin. I forgot my key card again.
No, this is Clarky O'Clyburn. Justin ain't here.
I don't have my swipe card. I left it at home. Can you let me in one last time?
I wish I could, but you know the rules. Since 1925, you got to use a two-digit number. Put it in, and then dial 685.
How possibly could we have cracked that code? What about Kathy and Judy? Do you have any Kathy and Judy memories?
They were two of the hottest women I've ever seen in my life. Between the two of them and Theda Bara, I tell you right now.
I had heard a rumor that you were romantically linked to Judy at one point.
Oh, Lord, that's it. Part of that's true. Not the whole thing, though.
right.
Part of that's true. Right. I didn't know which one I was dating.
Right. Well, how could you? Do you have any specific memories of the building you'd like to share?
Well, I started in 1925. I was 4 years old.
Okay. All right.
My dad came out of W1. We was poor. Mm-hmm. So I worked right away. Mm-hmm. William Deaver dedicated the building. And I remember the first day of the dedication, my father put me up on his shoulders. So I could see everything. I was only four, and that was the first day I had to actually make an arrest.
Okay. Well, what a sweet story. What a sweet, sweet story to tell.
It was my dad. He was pickpocketing.
I understand. Now, back in those days, we had some of the great gangsters of all time roaming the streets of Chicago. Did you know Al Capone?
Mr. Capone came in many times. He loved the Ritz Brothers. He thought they was the funniest guys ever. He'd come in to see the Ritz Brothers, but he had a thing going on with Patsy Kelly.
I have no idea who these people are. Do you know who these people are, Justin?
No.
Okay.
They were favorites of mine when I was a kid.
Oh, they were favorites of yours as well?
Okay.
Al Capone was shot and killed here by Bert Lahr.
I don't think that's true. I also don't think more than four people understand that joke.
It's a good Bert Lahr.
I'm also curious if you knew Colonel McCormick before he passed.
I did. He wasn't a colonel when I knew him. He was just a staff sergeant.
Okay, so eventually was promoted. I understand.
Yeah, I knew him a long time ago, but he's a great guy. And I told him, make those spices for the hamburger.
No, that's
and he
not.
Did.
Okay, sure.
He took my advice.
All right, so what do you think about us moving out of the building and the building being transitioned the way it's going to happen here with the...
Well, thank God. I'm just tired.
Right, you've had enough.
I'm in my late 90s. I got to go home.
All right, that's fine. That's fine.
I expected, I was hoping they'd give me something, you know, because I'm leaving, like, you know, maybe part of the pyramid or stuff that's in the walls.
Sure.
Great Wall of China.
Sure.
But the only thing I got was Tribune papers for the week. I don't get it on Sunday, but I get the papers for the week.
So that's your going away present.
I was like, thank you so much, because I, you know, I can't really read no more, but I'll do it.
Sure, of course you will. Well, listen, I want to thank you for all the work you've done here. You're a fine, fine individual, and you're a tribute to the Tribune Company.
Well, you're very kind. Unfortunately, you're under arrest.
I am?
Yeah.
I did not see that coming. All right. Well, listen, Clark, nice to talk to you.
Same to you, whatever you are.
Okay, that's Clark. He's a very old man. 98 now. Security guard here at the tower. Best of luck to you.